From inside Tropicana Field here in Tampa Bay, Interleague Baseball on MLB The Show. It's the St. Louis Cardinals taking on the Tampa Bay Rays. First pitch coming at you right after the break. Just about set to go. And starting on the mound for the Rays, Shane McClanahan. And Singy, we were talking earlier about how he's doing a great job navigating through tough spots.
I've just been so impressed with when it seems like there's more pressure, he's more calm and settles in. He's done an incredible job with runners in scoring position. Most guys, they get a little tight, they start to aim the baseball, but for some reason, he gets looser, the ball comes out of his hand with more life, and he's able to wiggle off the hook of, you know, tough situations and get his team back in the dugout.
Next one misses, and the count is 1-1. And now the lefty. And now 1-2. And a pitch. Hit in the air, right field. Phillips should have this one. And there's one away.
Batting second, the shortstop, Brendan Donovan.
Now the number two hitter, Brendan Donovan. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. The 0-1. Ground ball left side, and it goes just foul.
That fastball at the bottom of the zone can be very effective. Just got to keep it on the corners.
Next pitch misses. Now 1-2.
1 ball, 2 strikes.
No score, just getting started. Top of the first. Left-hand hitter waits. Rolled over to third. Paredes fires over to first. Quick start here this evening. Two out. Top of the first.
Arenado.
Here's Nolan Arenado. Arenado comes into this one with the 7th best batting average in the NL. And a foul ball. 2 outs.
Ball. 1-1.
That one blasted deep to right. That's back there. And it hits the fence. And that's a double.
Batting four. The first base.
He needed that one. It's been a tough stretch at the plate lately. So close to blasting that one out of here the other way. But that's very tough to do when you take on the outfield gap like that. Beautiful swing, though. Let the ball get a little deep and drove it to the opposite field.
Line drive. And that gets down for a base hit. Just kind of sliced that one into center.
The designated hitter, Albert's. Pujols.
And now it's Albert Pujols' turn to hit. Next pitch downstairs, and that's ball one. Lefty out of the stretch, runners at first and third. Breaking ball gets the corner for a strike. Pitch misses, and it's 2-1. That one missing inside. And the 3-1. And there's a foul ball. Arenado at third. Goldie on at first with two down. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Now it's the Rays' turn. No score. Bottom of the first. And now here's the starter for St. Louis, Jack Flaherty. And Chris, he's hoping for some better fortune moving forward.
Well, I'm looking to see if he can increase the amount of swings and misses and perhaps get more strikeouts, because hitters are batting over 300 against him, and that means guys are getting the barrel to the ball. Exit velocity's got to be pretty good when you have that kind of batting average, so he's going to have to find a way to do something different in this one.
We go to the bottom of the first at the plate. Brett Phillips. Next pitch has popped up. Brings it in, and there's one down.
Batting second, the first baseman, Harold Ramirez.
Harold Ramirez at the dish. It's interesting, he plays kind of a power spot defensively, but runs pretty well. So when you're looking at that position, you're not expecting someone that has maybe above average speed, but he does. And the 1-0. On the ground to third. And a couple of quick outs.
Batting third, the designated hitter, G-Man Choi.
Two outs, base is empty. And now the hitter, G-Man Choi. First pitch, and he just misses.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
The 1-0. Liner, base hit. And now it rolls all the way to the wall. Choi into second, and he's got a double.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. Pretty much just a textbook double into the gap. And when you can drop one in there between the outfielders, you know you're making the turn at first. Just an excellent swing.
Man at second here with two away. Now up for Tampa Bay, Brandon Lau. Good power, not great in the OBP department. Next offering is down low. 1-0. Bounce to the right side. Molina on to first. Lau out on the play. That ends the frame. One left for Tampa. We played an inning. No score. Top of the second. Here's Tyler O'Neill. He is quite an athlete. I mean, you look around the other sports, basketball, football, you feel like he could thrive in one of those sports too. And first offering is fouled off.
Look out. That ball was smoked. Man, I am so relieved that they have this netting down the lines. Just ensures safety for the fans. Last thing as a player, you want to look up and see a fan get hit. Umpiring behind the plate for us today, Boog, is Mike Fillmore, and he is a good one. He'll reward pitches on the edges a little bit, but the main thing is he doesn't keep you guessing. Once he established that a pitch is a strike, it stays that way.
Next offering misses, 2-1. Yeah, Fillmore, kind of, I don't know, you'd say maybe an umpire's umpire, but really consistent, very fair. Check swing, but he went too far. It's 2-2. The pitch. The other way. Phillips makes the grab, and there's one down.
Man, he smoked that fastball. He's all over it. It's just frustrating when you can't get it to fall. Maybe next time up, he'll find a hole.
Glenn Carlson. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Kicks and fires. Ball now 1-1.
That counts 1-1.
Good eye in that spot.
Count is 2-1.
No score here in the second. The next pitch misses, and that's ball three. Swing and a miss, 3-2 now.
When you throw a fastball by a guy like that, I imagine it's got to feel incredible. Look for him to throw it again at some point.
Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, a breaking ball in that 3-2 count kind of tells you that that's the pitch he has the most confidence in right now. Just couldn't find the strike zone.
Here's Corey Dickerson. First offering, misses the mark. Left-hand batter waits. And there's the strike. Second inning here, no score. Next offering is in for a strike.
Man, that pitch was dotted. So much talent on display when this guy's out there on the hill.
At the belt and fires. In the air, right side. Phillips settles underneath it and puts the squeeze on it. That's out number two.
The catcher, number four, Yadier Molina.
And stepping up to the dish is Yadier Molina. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. Can't get there, base hit. Runner around third on his way to the plate. He scores, and they have the lead. 1-0.
The batter number 19.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Challenged him with the fastball right in the heart of the zone, and he was clearly ready to jump all over it.
Back to the leadoff spot in the St. Louis lineup. Tommy Edman at the plate. This guy is one of the best athletes in the sport. Man on second, two down.
Love how vocal the umpire is today. No doubt in the hitter's mind, catcher's mind, and even the pitcher's mind as to the conviction in the call.
And the pitch stays alive. Molina stands at second with two gone. On the ground, right side. Lau sends it to first. Inning over, and it could have been worse. Cards on the board with this double. It's now 1-0. Back here at the ballpark, bottom half of inning number two, and here is Randy Arozarena. Flaherty back to work. Ball one low. And he gets tied up right there.
You tie a guy up like that, you're feeling like you are in command.
The wind of the pitch. Popped up on the left side of the infield. They get the out on Arozarena. One down. Now batting Wander Franco. Next pitch downstairs, and that is ball one. And the right-hander deals. Swing and a high fly ball left field. O'Neill under it. He makes the grab, and there's two down.
Fell off to a great start. He's really cruising out there on the mound. He's got a chance to get through these first two innings with under 20 pitches. That could set him up to go deep into this game.
Here's Kiermaier now.
Pretty amazing going way back. Possibly the best center fielder I've ever seen.
In there for strike one.
This lineup's going to have to find a way to make him work a little harder out there on the mound. I mean, he is just mowing them down. He's settling in. You got to make him uncomfortable. Maybe step out of the box, call timeout, do whatever it takes.
Over to Goldie. That's out number three. Rays held in check here. They trail here 1-0.
Leading off for the
Welcome
Cardinals.
Back. Top half of the third shortstop. Inning. Now here is Brendan Donovan. And a pitch. That clips the inside corner for a strike.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now. Here's the 0-2. Got him. And there's one away.
The batter, the third baseman, Nolan.
Here's Nolan Arenado.
Really good piece of hitting last time, going to the opposite field.
And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one. Fought off foul. Sharp grounder, that's through for a base hit.
Now batting, the first baseman.
Wasting no time. He's 2-for-2 now on the night. And just a triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, we're starting with this already. Now it's Goldschmidt up to the plate. First pitch, just misses.
Count 1-0.
The lefty, the 1-0. Now a screamer into the outfield. Kiermaier makes the catch, and there's two down.
The batter, number 5, designated hitter, Albert Pujols.
Here's Albert Pujols. In there, and it's 0-1. Next offering is in for a strike.
Perhaps not quite ready to hit. First two pitches by him for a couple of strikes. Now back is against the wall. He's going to have to figure something out and figure it out quickly.
1-2.
And a 1-2. And that one is lifted in the air. Phillips moving under it. Puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. The Cards leave one, but they hold a 1-0 lead.
Leading off for the Rays.
Mike Zunino. Zunino having more success against left-handed pitching this season, as might be expected. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Here's a 1-1. And a foul ball. Next pitch inside, and the count is 2-2. Righty delivers. And now the count filled up 3-2. And a pitch. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball 4.
And he reluctantly takes his walk.
Isaac Paredes now. Singh, you talked about a guy that has all the skills. The range is really good, but the arm just stands out, and he makes all the plays. Swings through that one, 0-1.
And because of that big power arm, he's able to play a little bit deeper, make throws from the outfield grass all the way across the diamond, and still get a pretty good runner. That's impressive.
Runner at first with no outs here. Next offering is foul back. Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing and a miss. Struck him out, and there's one down.
Well, classic pitch sequencing there to change eye levels for the punch out. That fastball on the pitch before was up. It was very competitive, and that gets you thinking that he might try to climb the ladder. But then the curveball out of that same tunnel just falls off the table, and you can't make contact.
Phillips in the box with one away as he takes ball one. And the righty deals. And it's 1-1. Kicks and deals. That one misses. 2-1. Zunino, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Swing and a miss. 2-2.
Knowing that the pitcher wants a ground ball double play opportunity here, you've got to lay off pitches down in the zone. Right there, swinging at that pitch, that's a no-no.
Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
Now batting.
Oh, nothing too fancy on the strikeout pitch right there. Just a low 90s fastball, and I'm not sure he was trying to challenge him, but that's pretty much what happened. Very hittable location, but he found a way to just get it by him.
Harold Ramirez, next to hit for the Rays. And that's in there for strike one. The pitch. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. His second of the year, and they jump out front. It's 2-1.
A hanger, and pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
Now G-Man Choi getting ready to hit. Doubled his first time up. He swings and fouls one off. The next offering misses. Ball one. The wind and the pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. The pitch. Good eye right there.
I got to count 2-2.
2-2 now. Swings and pulls it foul to the right side. Oh, now this is blasted. Way back there. On its way. Gone. And Choi pops one out of here. His ninth homer of the year. It's 3-1.
Back-to-back homers, always a special feeling at the ballpark, especially if it's your team that does it and those guys get to slap hands at home plate. This is the kind of thing that can really fire up the ballpark.
Base is empty with two away. And now it's Brandon Lau. Next offering is down low. And it's 1-0. This to center field. Dickerson glides back, makes the grab, and that's the inning. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. And this is now a 3-1 ball game. Back here at Tropicana Field as we go to the top of the fourth. Now up for St. Louis, Tyler O'Neill. Check swing, but he went too far. It's 0-1.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team.
Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Makes the turn and heads for second. Not stopping. He's going for three. And he makes it into third with a leadoff triple.
Oh, a swing like that can help you come out of this struggle. We saw the numbers coming into the ball game, but all he's trying to do at this point is help his team win.
Next to hit, Dylan Carlson. And first offering is fouled off. O'Neill, the lone runner, stands at third with nobody out. Next pitch misses inside. One ball, one strike. On the ground, right side. And he'll be safe at first.
The center fielder, number 25, Corey Dickerson.
Corey Dickerson, next up for the Cardinals. He's 0 for 1. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. And the lefty with the 0-1. On the ground, right side, and he picks it up, and he'll put it in his pocket. 0-2 now. In the air, left field, down the line. A Rosarena puts the squeeze on that one, and there's one down.
The catcher, number 3, Yadier Molina.
And now the Cardinals catcher, Yadier Molina. He doubled home a run in his first AB. Pitch misses inside, ball one. And here it comes. Here's the pitch, runner on the goal. Zunino throw, got him! Why to kick the pitch. That one's in there, and the count is 1-2. And he deals. And he hits a ground ball right side. Can't glove it cleanly, but in time. Nice job to stay with it to end the inning. To the bottom of inning number 4 now. Rays 3 and the Cardinals 2. Back now in Tampa Bay. Now it's Randy Arozarena. Larry back to work.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, he's gotten ahead with two pitches down in the zone. He has plenty of options right here. He can go up, he can go away, he can add velocity, he can subtract.
The pitch. Up the middle, base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
The batter, number 5.
Just kept it simple, played Pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there's just no one there to knock it down. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Here's Wander Franco. He's 0 for 1. That one's in there, 0-1. Next pitch is outside.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or run and hit.
That one's in there. And a count 1-2. The pitch. And that chance handled. The throw to first. Franco gone on the play.
Up next for Tampa Bay, the center fielder, Kevin Kiermaier.
Here's Kevin Kiermaier. Singing, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. First pitch, and he just misses.
And I would say that most great defensive outfielders, it's kind of natural. There is some work that you can do to it to improve your game, but ultimately, you either have it or you don't.
Next pitch misses way outside. Next offering is fouled back. Two two now. That one missed. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And there's two away.
Now batting, the catcher, Mike
Zunino, the next to hit. He walked and came around to score his first time up. In there, and it's 0-1.
Not what he's looking for there in the 0-0 count. Looks like he wants the ball down in his own.
The pitch. And a foul ball. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. That one in the dirt. Gets to it on to first. Throw pumps him off the bag, and he's safe. Here's the third baseman, Isaac Paredes.
If he can get through this one, put up a zero, this will help in his outings to come.
Bullpen activity starting up now. Jake Woodford preparing to come on if needed. And the 1-0. A swing and a miss, and that's strike one.
Really consistent release point. He's been able to pitch up and down and have excellent command at both locations.
Next one misses, and it's 2-1.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
Next offering is fouled back. Oh, right to the backstop. And the runners will move up. And here's a 3-2. Swing and a miss, and that is that. So the Rays strand a pair, and it remains a 3-2 ball game. And welcome back. Top five, John Ciambi with Chris Singleton. And leading it off, Tommy Edman. Here comes a pitch. Phillips sizing this one up. Got it. Really had to move for that grab. And there's one away. And up next for St. Louis.
On the mound, very efficient, able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at-bat.
Next offering is down low. One down, base is empty. That one fouled off. Puts it in the air out towards left center. That's a hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
The batter, the third baseman, Nolan Arenado.
Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
And now Nolan Arenado. And the first pitch misses for ball one. The 1-0. And another ball.
Last two pitches have been down in the zone. Pitcher clearly trying to get that ground ball double play. But in this count, you're going to have to give in, elevate his pitches, and get back into this at bat.
No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there are two outs. Here's Paul Goldschmidt. And first offering is fouled off. Next pitch is downstairs. The 1-1. And that one fouled off. Stays alive. And down on strikes he goes. Third out, that ends the frame. So one left for the Cardinals. They're down 3-2.
Leading off.
Back here at the ballpark, we head to the bottom of the fifth. Here's the
Brett Phillips.
The right-hander back to work. And takes low for ball one. And a big swing and a miss. In the air, left field. O'Neill in position. Squeezes it, and there's one down.
The first baseman, Harold Ramirez.
Ramirez up for the third time here. Watches that one miss. Next pitch way upstairs. Righty to the plate. And there's a strike.
Now, there's a pitch we haven't seen in a while. It's going to be tough on the hitters if he can mix that in whenever he wants.
To the left side, but it is well fouled. Line drive, base hit.
Now batting, the designated hitter, G-Man Choi.
Choi up to the plate for the third time as he looks at one down low. And the 1-0 to short could be two. Good feed. That's one on to first. Double play, and that's the inning. Five innings complete. Rays 3 and the Cardinals 2. Matt Whistler on to pitch out of the pen here, and he'll do his best to hang on to this lead.
Well, at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and we get a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
And here it comes. Pujols up to hit for the third time as he lays off inside ball one. The 1-1. And that one fouled off. Kicks and fires. Right side. And foul ball. Got him. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. And stepping in for the Cardinals, Tyler O'Neill. 1-2. And that's in there for strike one.
0-1.
bounced up the middle, and that one finds its way through. So a man aboard now with one away.
The right fielder, number three, Dylan Carlson.
And here is Dylan Carlson. Ground ball right side, could be two. Oh, can't pick it up cleanly. No throw. He's safe at first.
I think he just rushed that one. Great chance to turn two. And as an infielder on a play like that, I think guys can get a little excited and forget to make the play one step at a time. Could have been two outs. Instead, they get none.
Here's Dickerson down. Check swing, but he went too far. And it's 0-1.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
Next offering is in for a strike. Deal two. Line drive, base hit. The Rosarena fires it to the plate. Slide, save. Back even, it's 3-3.
Back-to-back singles, that pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay. Now a huge at-bat in this game coming up.
First offering is fouled off. Carlson, the lead runner at second. Dickerson at first. One gone. 0-2 as he waves at that one. Next offering misses, and it's 1-2. Popped up right side. Loud under it. Drops into the glove. Two down.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity, but competitor like him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at bat.
Tommy Edman next up for the Cardinals. This guy has turned into a beast. First offering misses the mark. The 1-0. And that one off the outside edge. Line to right, and this one could be extra bases. Headed for the plate. The throw to second. Runner holds at third, so just one across on the play.
Well, there you go. The RBI machine. Another clutch run scoring at bat.
Yeah, he's been so good in these situations. Call it clutch if you want, but his resume speaks for itself. Now at the plate, Brendan Donovan brings it in for the third out. To the bottom of the sixth we go. 4-5-6 coming up. It's the Cardinals 4 and the Rays 3. A new arm into the game. The righty, Nick Wickred. He last pitched 2 days ago.
Nick Wickred. And
welcome back. Here's the second baseman, Brandon Lau.
Brandon
Lau. The pitch. And ball one. And the 1-0. Swing and a foul back. That's out of play.
Just missed. If he's able to connect on that, look out.
At the belt and fires. This one chopped on the ground, but foul. And the right-hander deals. And a swing and a miss. Leadoff man retired
now
in the sixth.
Left fielder, Randy.
Randy or Rosarena, next to hit for the Rays. In there for strike one. Activity in the bullpen. Cody Whitley, the young right-hander, up and throwing. And a pitch. On the ground right side. It's off his shoulder. Eats him up.
The batter, number 5. Shortstop, Wander.
Stepping in is the switch hitting shortstop, Wander Franco. That one's in there, 0-1.
Well, they say it's the best pitch in baseball. Strike one. You get ahead on a good hitter as well. Gives a little bit more confidence to move through the at-bat.
Right-hander kicks, deals. And now it's even up. Tying run is at first as the Rays try and punch back down a run. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Pulls it down and he makes the catch.
Now back.
And there are two down.
Kevin Kiermaier.
And stepping in for the Rays. He's a guy, Chris, whose highlights include some of the best throws from the outfield that you will ever see. Definitely one of the best arms in the sport. And first offering is fouled off. The 0-1. And that's in for a strike. A Rosarena off of first with two away. And the 0-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. And that one almost got him. Here's a 1-2. Stays alive. Two outs. That's a hit. They stopped the lead runner at second. Now two on with two outs. A perfect example right there. That plate discipline, it pays off.
The deeper he gets into a count, the more comfortable he becomes, and he usually wins the battle.
So first and second with two outs. And now Mike Zunino. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Yeah, I'm surprised we didn't see a visit from the pitching coach here. Just to remind him, focus on the hitter. Don't worry about anything else.
The 1-0. This one popped up right side. And it drops in. So that's two straight two-out hits. Runner at third puts on the brakes. Base is now loaded with two away.
Couple of hits in a row for him here. Kind of your classic jam shot blooper right there. Made a good pitch on the inside. Gotten to hit it off the handle, but he still muscled it out there. You just have to tip your cap on the mound. And another big at-bat coming up here. Looking for a way to get that tying run across with two outs.
Isaac Paredes stands in with two away as he takes a ball. That one lifted to left. O'Neill under it makes the catch, and that is that. And the Rays leave them loaded. They still trail it here 4-3. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Shane Batts. This is his first appearance of the season. We go to the top of the seventh. Now the third baseman, Nolan Arenado. Pitch. Now a high fly ball out to left center. Kiermaier racing over to make the catch.
The batter, the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
And next is the Cardinals' four hitter, Paul Goldschmidt. Next pitch downstairs, and that's ball one. That one misses in the dirt.
Not showing great command so far in this at bat. 2-0 count. He's got to execute here or this could get ugly.
Comes up empty. That's strike two.
Just not able to catch up to that velocity.
This to third. Whips it across. Two up, two down.
Designated hitter, Albert Pujols.
So now here's the Cardinals designated hitter, Albert Pujols. And fouled off. Two down, nobody on. And it's fouled away. Right-handed reliever on the ground. Paredes fires over to first. And that'll do it. 1-2-3 go to Cardinals. And it remains a 4-3 game. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Cody Whitley trying to protect this lead.
Cody Whitley.
And leading back off, now in Tampa Rays. Bay, bottom of the seventh. The right now it's the right fielder, Brett Phillips. The pitch. That one off the mark, 1-0. Ripped to the right center. Should be extra bases. Around first and hustling for second. And now the tying run is into scoring position.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock. Now we'll see if they can pick up that tying run and start us over here in the late innings.
Ramirez, the next to hit, takes low for a ball. Two balls, no strikes, the count.
Yeah, Boog, if you're that base runner at second base, you want to be quiet out there. Not bouncing around, not distracting your teammate, the hitter. Make sure that he can clearly focus on that pitcher and that release point.
Swing and a miss, and it's 2-1. Runner leads away at second. And delivers outside.
Really been able to slow down the game tonight with his at-bats, and the biggest one he's had so far. He doesn't look anxious at all.
That one the other way, and it's caught for the out.
Now batting, the designated hitter, G-Man George.
G-Man George, next to hit for the Rays.
Been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
Phillips, the runner at second with one away. This one pulled down the line. It's hammered. This one hooking. It's got a chance. Foul.
Felt a little anxious on that changeup right there. It tells you he's ready to hit a fastball. If he can let that thing get deeper as he recognizes it out of the hand, tell you what, he could be circling the bases.
Makes the grab. Runner tags at second, and he's up to third safely with two balls.
Second baseman, Brandon Lau.
Lau at the plate. And there's no doubt that they'll feed off the energy from this crowd, right?
I mean, yeah, I'd say the intensity level has gone up a few notches for sure.
And first offering is fouled off. And that one lifted in the air, center field. Dickerson drifts towards it. And that is that. The Rays strand just the one. Score holds at 4-3.
Leading off
back here at Tropicana Field, we go to the eighth. Now the left fielder, Tyler O'Neill. Swings and misses. Slider right there. Ball one there. So now 1-2. Righty delivers. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. Now one out.
Very frustrating right there as a speedy potential base runner when with two strikes you just struggle to put the ball in play. You don't even have to get a hit at that point. You can help your team just by reaching on an error. But some way you got to find a way to shorten up the swing and put the ball in play next time.
The 0-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. That's the third. Paredes picks it up. Not in time. He's safe.
Did a nice job getting there. Good throw, but very difficult to get anybody on that one as far as you had to go and throw. You know?
Yeah, no question. Now here is Corey Dickerson. One for three. Here comes the pitch. There goes the runner from first. Swing and a miss. Zunino throw. Got him. And the 0-1.
I got one ball, one strike.
And a ground ball to first. Ramirez takes it to the bag, and it's a 1-2-3 inning. Ryan Helsley gets the ball now. And this guy can bring it velocity-wise.
Number 56, Ryan Helsley. Leading off.
Ready for the bottom of the eighth. Now up for Tampa Bay, Randy Arozarena.
You know, this guy's great speed is in the back of that pitcher's mind. If he can get on, it's going to give him one more thing he's got to think about.
That's through there for a strike. Movement in the bullpen for the Cardinals. Giovanni Gallegos appears to be getting loose. The wind of the pitch. Foul ball. And the righty deals. And 1-2.
I don't like to say he wasted a pitch. I think that was a purpose pitch. Change the eye level, have him look up. Now go back exactly where you want to go.
Line drive, base hit.
The batter, number 5.
Oh, this has been a really nice game at the plate for him. He looks locked in. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Franco in the box now, takes strike one. Nobody out, runner at first. And a pitch. Gonna count 1-2.
Well, with the amount of pitches that can end up in the dirt, a good secondary lead doesn't have to get away from the catcher. But if you're anticipating based off the trajectory, get yourself into scoring position. Well, that's not the best two-strike fastball I've seen, but certainly got away with the location there. You know, sometimes as a hitter, when you're down in the count, you're so focused on a pitcher painting the black, and you just get a little bit locked up on something down the heart of the plate.
Fires to second for one. Return throw to first. Got him. Double play. And that'll do it. Ninth inning coming up. It's the Cardinals 4 and the Rays 3.
Leading off for the
All set for the start of the inning. Now up for St. Louis, Yadier Molina. The pitch. And a foul ball. And a pitch. And a swing and a miss.
That's one of those swing now before the pitchers even let go of the baseball.
Kicks and deals. And takes low for ball one.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Stays alive.
Well, he's desperately looking for that swing and miss. He's going to have to just change speeds a little bit, try to move it around, create just a little bit of illusion at the end.
Next pitch has popped up. Ramirez moving under this one. One down.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
And here's the St. Louis leadoff man, Tommy Edman. Popped up. And that's a foul ball. And he deals. And there's a fly ball deep right field. That's going back. Back some more. Pulls it in on the warning track. Brendan Donovan now at the plate.
Not looking like they'll be adding any insurance runs heading to the bottom of the ninth, so it's going to be on the bullpen to hold this lead.
Next pitch misses, and the count even 1-1. And here it comes. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. One run game here in the top of the ninth. To the right side. Lau sends it to first, and that is that. 8-9-1 due up in the bottom of inning number 9. It's the Cardinals 4 and the Rays 3. Now they turn to Giovanni Gallegos. Hasn't pitched in a while. He's had the last 5 days off.
Number 65.
And the batter now, Mike Zunino. He's built his reputation as one of the top framers in the sport. The pitch. Ball one, no strikes.
Home plate umpires trying to tighten things up a little bit.
Swing and a miss. And a count 1-1. Here comes a pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Here's a 1-2. And a swing and a miss. And that is a big first out.
Now batting.
Well, that right there is what you want to see out of your closer. Come in and close the door. Cancel any hope that that opponent has in making some type of comeback in the ballgame. Tell you what, that helps him settle in, and that helps everybody else relax a little bit to get these other two outs.
And first offering is fouled off. Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. Next offering is fouled back. Hit softly on the ground to third. Arenado to first in time. And that quickly two away. Now it's going to be Brett Phillips. I think when you contemplate him as a player, the first thing you think about is defense, and you think about that great arm.
I also think about the speed. If he can get on, that's going to give one more thing for that pitcher to think about.
And a foul ball. Ripped to short, snagged on a bounce. Throw to first, ball game. And the Cardinals hold on to win a tight one as this one ends as a one-run ball game.
Well, Boone, 4 games wasn't too long of a losing streak, but they're definitely happy to be back in the win column. Now you can turn things around, get on the right track, and probably start a winning streak from here.
final line score tonight. First for the Victoria.